Hey everybody, Erek here. Thanks so much for tuning in. I hope you're going okay. I love video game music, and it's really hard to deny the fact that without a good soundtrack or good music, you can't have a great game. You know, sometimes all it takes is a catchy kind of earworm like the Mario Brothers theme song, or perhaps something that has more of a life outside of the video game, like the Final Fantasy VII soundtrack, perhaps. The recipe for success with a good video game is a great soundtrack. It is definitely foundational. Over the last 10 years, I've had the pleasure of working on a bunch of video game music related stuff through my side project, Retro Game Remix. I've released 11 albums, over 100 songs, and 3 vinyl records, 1, 2, and 3 behind me. So it's fair to say that not only have I been digging into these songs, not to just enjoy them more, but also to understand them more on a molecular level, I suppose. But here's the thing that changed it all for me. Back in 2020, when there were never-ending lockdowns and the world was shut down, I spent a lot of time researching video games and music alike, and thank the YouTube gods that recommended me this. Soon discovered the world of bands like tsquare and Cassiopeia, and it's safe to say that it totally changed my life. And while digging deeper into tsquare's discography in particular, I noticed something really interesting. Like, really, really interesting. Well, I've actually heard some of these songs before. Kind of. Have you ever wondered who some of your favorite video game composers are inspired by? I mean, I personally love Nobuo Uematsu, and it's super clear he's heavily inspired by lots of classic rock, progressive rock, and even some more classical and orchestral works. I mean, look at tracks like One Winged Angel. It's a classic rock, prog rock orchestra. This perfectly encapsulates his style. But what about some others? The purpose of today's video is really just to show you guys how influential and how inspirational the music was in the 1980s in Japan on video games. And it's so funny because I feel like once you guys hear these, you're going to be like, oh, it all makes sense now. Check this out. The first record we're going to be looking at today is Adventures by tsquare. Now, there's a very familiar song on here. Let's have a look at Sister Marion. Does that sound familiar to you? You bet. It's fair to say that Koji Kondo was pretty well inspired by tsquare, and if it weren't for tsquare having written this song back in the early 80s, we may not have ever had that classic Mario Brothers theme. Next up is Travelers from the same album, which sounds like this. And of course, right away, you kind of know who might have borrowed from that. Have a listen. Now, do you see what I mean? It's pretty clear that some of these composers not only quite heavily borrowed from some of the phrasing or styles, but they were also listening to the music of the time, which was really popular in Japan. And that's why I wanted to highlight these songs and this particular band, tsquare, to show you guys, well, maybe they were the real pioneers of video game music. I've got 2 more examples for you today, and they both come from the same album again, which was released by tsquare in 1990, and this album is called Natural. Now, the first track we're listening to on this one is called Control. Oh boy, get your Wiimotes out because this one sounds oddly familiar. That's right, if you heard the Wii Sports title theme in there, you're not alone, because as soon as I heard that song when I first got into tsquare, I was like, oh my god, it's Wii Sports! Second up on this record is Wind Song. If you're a Sonic fan like I am, you probably realize that it has the same kind of motif and phrasing as the Lava Reef Zone from Sonic and Knuckles. Check it out. A It's not just limited to those examples. I mean, look at Wave Race 64. That's a great soundtrack. It's really poppy, fusion-y, boppy. The main instrument in most of the songs is the EWI, which is the electronic wind instrument, which is prominently featured in tsquare. Think of it as like an electronic saxophone. It's really cool, really unique, and boy oh boy, there's a lot of similarities there, and I love it. I'm all for it. The guitarist from tsquare, Masahiro Ando, has had his hand in several composition projects over the years, such as Ark the Lad. The soundtrack is insanely good, and gameplay is really unique if you like JRPGs. And of course, Gran Turismo with the iconic Moon Over Castle, Gran Turismo's theme song. Gran Turismo's Moon Over Castle also makes an appearance on this album right here by tsquare, Blue and Red, as Night Song. And guess who plays the EWI on this one? Masato Honda. Any anime fans out there? You guys have heard of the Seatbelts, Tank, Cowboy Bebop? Well, he plays sax on that. There you go. Cool, isn't it? Now, even the drummers from tsquare, like Hiroyuki Noritake and Satoshi Bando, who has done some Gran Turismo composition himself, will go on to participate in Mario Kart 8's soundtrack. Plus, if you like the Mario Kart 8 original soundtrack, try listening to Dimension. They're literally the band that plays on the soundtrack. It's so cool. It's fair to say that the music scene in 1980s in Japan was incredibly influential and inspirational on a lot of different artists, games alike. It was one of their best kept secrets until recently. I mean, after listening to video game music my whole life and now discovering Japanese jazz fusion, I just feel like everything clicks. I feel like I finally found my sound. I found my music. It's really cool and it just feels really personal to me. And that's why I felt compelled to make this video. So do you guys like tsquare? Do you like Japanese jazz fusion? Have you guys listened to bands like Cassiopeia, tsquare, Dimension? So many great connections between classic video game songs and Japanese jazz fusion and city pop artists. If anything, I just wanted to kind of make more of a the more you know video. So I'm very happy to make this video today. Yeah, leave a comment down below. Make sure if you like this video, leave a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and leave a comment and let's just chat about music. We'll see you on the next video. Thanks for watching.